What's up, y'all? Welcome back to Fish the Moment. In my last video, I talked about when to fish offshore during the spawn to post-spawn transition. And now that you guys know when to fish offshore, you probably want to know where to fish offshore in the post-spawn. And so in this video, I'm going to break down which types of areas I look for offshore during the post-spawn on several different types of lakes to give you an idea of where you can start looking offshore during that spawn to post-spawn transition. So let's get into it. So bass are actually pretty easy to find offshore during the spawn to post-spawn transition because they'll set up on pretty much the same types of areas on all different lakes around the country. And I actually have a general rule of thumb that you can use to locate these bass during the post-spawn offshore. And what I look for are places there between the spawning pockets and the deepest water out in the middle of the lake, whether that's a main river channel, or it's just a deep hole in the middle of a small lake, or any type of deep water. And deep water is very relative to the type of body of water you're fishing. And on Table Rock Lake, deep water may be 80 to 90 feet of water in the main river channel. And on a Florida lake, deep water may be 6 to 8 feet of water off the bank 200 or 300 yards away from the shoreline. And so deep water is very relative, and I'll give you examples of all these different types of fisheries in the rest of this video. So to better explain this rule of thumb, let's jump into the first type of lake, which is a deep clear lake. And for this example, I'm going to be using Table Rock Lake because that's where I've been fishing a lot recently. And I've been catching a lot of fish on Table Rock Lake on main lake and secondary points. They're between the spawning pockets and the main river channel. And so on this image from Navionics, you'll see that these are the spawning pockets where the bass spawned in March, April, and the beginning of May. And then here's the main river channel, which is the deepest stretch of water in this part of the lake where the bass like to set up during the summertime when it gets really hot. So in general, during the spawn, most of the bass in this area are going to be in the spawning pocket or close to it. And then after they finish spawning, they're going to start transitioning away from the spawning pocket out to that main river channel where they want to spend their summer. And they normally don't make this move from the spawning pocket to the main river channel in one go. And they need to stop on intermediate places between the spawning pockets and this main river channel to rest and feed up and get more energy before they get all the way out to the main lake. And so whenever I'm fishing offshore on deep clear lakes in the post-spawn, I'm going to be looking for structures there between the spawning pocket and the main river channel. And these structures can be points, humps, ditches, high spots, really any type of structure that would hold bass in any other time of the year. But it needs to be between the spawning pocket and the main river channel. So for example, this point right here is one where I've been catching a lot of good fish offshore on Table Rock Lake in the post-spawn. And I've been catching post-spawn spotted bass, largemouth, and smallmouth off this point. And these bass are using this point as a staging area before they move all the way out to the main river channel here. And I've been catching these bass in anywhere from 10 to 35 feet of water off this point. And it seems like these bass are sitting in shallower water right after they get off the beds. So if they spawned at the last week of April, maybe the first or second week of May, they're in 10 to 15 feet of water. Then in mid-May, they may be in 20 feet of water. And then now at the end of May, they're actually in 30 to 35 feet of water. And then there's also bass setting up on these other main lake and secondary points between the spawning pockets and the main river channel. And these bass are setting up on points, on humps, on high spots, all kinds of different types of structures. And so it's not just points that I'm fishing this time of year. It's any structure between the spawning pocket and the main lake. And if you need a refresher on the different types of structures that bass hold on, check out this video that I have on my channel, which is a complete guide to contour line maps. And I break down all the different types of structures I look for when I bass fish using Navionics and Google Earth, so they're very easy to understand. And as long as you look for those types of structures in the areas I mentioned, you'll be finding fish on these deep clear lakes. So next up, let's talk about dirty water lakes. And a dirty water lake is any lake where the water has less than 2 feet of water visibility, so you can't see your bait down more than 2 feet into the water. And the same rule of thumb for deep clear lakes applies to these dirty water lakes as well. And whenever I'm fishing offshore on dirty water lakes, I'm going to be looking for places that have a contour line change, so pieces of structure that are between the spawning pockets and the main river channel or the deepest part of the lake. So for an example of a dirty water lake, I'm going to be using Lake Uchi in Oklahoma. And this lake has a lot of good offshore humps and points and ditches. and the bass will spawn in the backs of these creeks. And then they're going to want to summer on the main river channel out here. And so as the bass are transitioning out of these creeks after they spawn, they're going to be pulling up on these secondary points, small turns on these flats, high spouts out in the middle of the lake out here, or any type of structure between the main river channel and the back of that creek. And I've been catching some really good fish over the last few weeks, fishing these secondary points, these high spots, and these ledges there between the creeks and the main river channel. And it's a great way to catch good fish in the post-spawn, because a lot of guys won't be looking at these areas. They'll be focusing on the main river channel spots where they get in the summer, or they're focusing in the back of the creeks. And they don't fish these intermediate areas where most of the fish are during the post-spawn. Next up, let's talk about river systems. And river systems work pretty much the same way as the deep clear lakes and the muddy water lakes. And really, what you'll find on a river system is that these bass are going to spawn in backwaters. And a backwater is basically a place that's off the main river, that's less affected by current, and that may be behind some islands or back in the creek. And so a lot of fish will move into these backwaters to spawn. And then after they spawn, they're going to work their way back to the main river channel. And you can actually find a lot of fish offshore on river systems on sandbars and sandbar drops. They're in the mouth of these creeks or these backwaters off the river. And a sandbar drop is basically any place off the end of a sandbar, which is basically just a big pile of sand on the side of the river, where the end of that sandbar drops sharply into deep water. And so, for example, the end of the sandbar may be in 4 or 5 feet of water, and it drops straight into 15 or 20 feet of water. And these bass will set up right on the lip of that drop, and they'll feed up on shad and all kinds of things in the post-spawn. And it's just like fishing a ledge or fishing any sort of point that you would see on a normal lake, except for they're called sandbar drops on the rivers. And I'll be making videos about sandbar drops here in the near future once the Arkansas River stops flowing 500,000 cubic feet per second. And so sandbars are going to be all shifted around too. But I'll definitely make a video on sandbar drop fishing, because it is a really good way to catch fish. And there are literally zero videos on YouTube that explain it well. And so I will have that video out as soon as the Arkansas River calms down. And then last but not least, let's talk about natural lakes. And natural lakes are lakes like you would have in Florida or up in the Northeast, where the lake pretty much looks like a big bowl. And you don't have very defined contour lines, and you don't have things like creek channels or a main river channel. And so it may be hard to figure out where to fish offshore, because it's not as clear cut on these natural lakes. And so when I'm looking for fish offshore in the post-spawn on these natural lakes, I'm looking for very subtle contour line changes that are just off the bank and that are kind of in front of the deepest water in the lake. So for example, here is a spot on Lake Harris on the Harris chain in Florida, and it's just two high spots that are in the mouth of this canal that connect two of the Harris chain lakes together. And a lot of these bass will spawn up on the banks here. And then after they spawn, they're going to pull out to these high spots because they're the only contour line changes in this area. And a lot of times these places will have hard bottom or shell beds on top of them where the bass can feed up after they spawn. And these areas are kind of between the deeper water out here and the shallow spawning areas. Even though the deep water isn't really that deep, it's still a deep water area when you look relative to all the water on these natural lakes. Another area I would check out is this very long, wide, subtle point right off the bank on the Harris chain. And this point is very subtle, but it's definitely there, and if I shade it, you can see it pretty clearly. And this point has grass up on top of it, and these bass will pull out off the bank onto this offshore point. And you kind of have to just fish around this point looking for hard spots, looking for concentrations of bass on this big expansive flat. But these are the types of offshore places that bass will get on these Florida lakes. And some of these natural lakes are going to have deeper water. You can actually fish deep diving crankbaits, or they may have an actual ledge, things like that. But a lot of these lakes won't have those defined contour lines. You need to look for these subtle contour line changes and these subtle offshore areas to catch fish. So guys, that's it for this video. I hope this gave you a better understanding of where to start looking offshore during that spawn to post-spawn transition. And if you didn't check out my last video about when to fish offshore during the post-spawn, check out that video in the link in the description below. And other than that, hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll see you next time. Hey guys, thanks for checking out the video. Hope you enjoyed, and if you want more content from Fish the Moment, check out my website, fishthemoment.com. On my website, I offer virtual fishing lessons you can do from your home using Google Hangout, on the water fishing lessons where you can go out in your boat and I can show you how to find fish with your electronics and on the water, and also lake breakdowns of some of those popular lakes around the country where I'll give spot recommendations, conditions, and lure recommendations as well. And if you really enjoyed the video and you want to support the channel in a more personal way, donate on my Patreon page. On Patreon, you can give a small monthly donation that helps me continue to make quality content for you guys into the future. And last but not least, check out my social media pages. I'm on Facebook and Instagram, and I post a lot of great pictures, videos, and articles about bass fishing. So thanks again for checking out this video, and I'll see you in the next one.